I am back in the workshop. Welcome everyone to Wintergatan Wednesday's 2020 edition. Do you know the Roman name for 2020? It's MMXX. So MMX completion in MMXX. Woohoo! Before I left 5 weeks ago on my European trip, I made a design push and the result materialized in form of these deliveries. So today we're gonna open these deliveries and plan ahead for how to put all these parts onto the Marmoshin X. My studio is a huge mess, there's no floor space. This is not a proper engineering environment. I'm gonna build a new work table and I'm gonna have it on wheels. 4G internet, boop. No internet, done. But Martin, don't you have a phone as well? Yes, I have. My phone is lying here and it's not gonna leave this spot. And I'm checking my phone once in the morning and once in the night. It's the morning of day one of the Marble Machine X completion. Let's go. Look at this, we already have some more space. This working table has not been functioning so well. I'm gonna rebuild this, also not sturdy. I just got an idea. I don't know plumbing, but my superpower is the angle grinder. I can remove the tap. And now we can safely just remove the whole furniture. And what's so great with this method is that you still have water if you need it.
Definition of legit.
Like on my trip to Scandinavia, I didn't see the sun for a month. Coming home to France and it's just 21 degrees and birds are singing. Didn't spark joy. Look at this weather. Cheers everyone for 2020. The year where I'm plugging my merch and finishing the Marble Machine X. So the requirements for the work table is that it's sturdy. It has to hold all this equipment. It should be easy to move. Last requirement is that I can only use scrap materials that I have lying at home. So let's go find some. So I think this dimensions for the legs. This is acoustic materials for my music studio. We have a very exciting project coming up. Shout out to Olivier and his friends at ID Acoustic. So I'm just laying out the machines that I want to fit on the bottom shelf. We also need to leave place for the argon tube. We're in the CAD program and I replied to the WhatsApp messages, turning my phone off. Be gone. Here's my quick and dirty work table and I'm very happy that I did it in CAD because it let me think about stuff. For example, that I want to be able to clamp on the side here and here, and also down here that I want leg room down here. I now know how I can use my scrap material to the best. Let's make a cutting list out of this. Let's just start to cut some wood. So it's afternoon, day one, and so far no procrastination. And this table build is not procrastination itself. This is a much needed improvement on my shop. Do you remember this thing from the Dragon Slayer project? That must have been the worst project of the Marble Machine X. Now I can turn it into a work table. I still have the wounds from the dragon slaying though. It's like Frodo, I will always carry that wound. That's the moon up there. It's getting a little bit late. I thought I was going to be able to finish the workbench on day one. I didn't, been working the whole day. I feel great about it. Tomorrow, gonna finish the workbench. Good morning, day two. Today we're building the frames. Repeat 100 times. So on this third frame, the front is inset like this to give me place to stand on the floor, leg room here.
And I'm adding this 8mm steel under the legs to lift them up from the ground. So this is now standing on the wheels. I'm going to make the workbench have two modes, on wheels or on the legs. So on the legs when I'm working and on the wheels for transportation. I don't have to measure anything. I just know which pieces should be flush with each other. That's everything I need to know basically. Oh, yes. This leg is leaning a little bit outwards. I'm gonna try to pull it square with this band here. Yeah, better. I love the monolithness of it all. Starting to feel pretty sturdy now. We're getting there. Rolling nicely, but as you can see, it's not really sturdy when the wheels are activated. So now I'm gonna make the leg extensions so I can lock the table down. So far, so good. I'm gonna send this to You Make It, We Skate It. Good luck kick flipping that. Okay, so here's my idea. I'm gonna lift the table up. The wheels are now 8mm off the ground. Then we're gonna use this one. Two washers into here. Now we're on the wheels and now we're on the leg. So on the other side of the bench, I'm gonna mount the argon bottle and that will be a collision here. I don't like to increase the footprint of the whole table when I'm moving it around. I have a new solution. I'm gonna put them here on the front side. So this is rolling and this is leg. And this will increase the width of the feet we will have from here to here, which will stabilize in this direction. Good morning for day three. This has been my temporary music studio. 2020 is going to be more serious for music, so we're gonna redo the whole music studio. When I removed a wall, this bathroom appeared. Today we have a plumber coming in so we can remove this whole bathroom, and I'm going to finish the workbench. This is a temporary countertop. This is actually made from cardboard. I'm gonna replace this with something with massive wood. But for now, it will do. Where there was a bathroom this morning, it's now empty space. The bathroom has been taken away. This leaves so much more space for us to plan the studio properly. And if you remember the tap hanging off the wall here, the tap is also gone. Whee! The workbench is done. Check this out. So, let me show you some features. Bottom shelf, air compressor, poubelle, garbage bin, welding machine, welding equipment. Side here, argon fire department, cables for the welder and electricity for the whole workbench. Down here, I can plug in anything and the machines are always plugged in. Middle shelf, this is the area that's going to be contamination zone right away. Top that I'm going to switch as soon as I can. For la pièce de résistance. When I want to build, I want the table more sturdy. With a very simple movement, I can lock the table because these have some leverage, so they lift the table up. There we go. And it's rock solid. So let me show you the shot I always wanted to film. So I like to film the table from the other side like this, and a marble machine in the background, something like this. So now I can work here, film this shot, and I can assemble things. And as soon as I'm done with this and I need to do something else, I can switch over to rolling mode, like so. I can move the whole bench over to resting position in front of the window here. And voila, I can have a whole dance floor here now. Another super important thing. So the reason that the welder is upstairs is that I need to weld on the marble machine X. I can just roll the welder over there, take my welding equipment, weld, and hang it back neatly. Neatly is my kryptonite. So now I can finally make the unboxing that I wanted to make this whole video. Before I left for my 5-week European road trip, I made a lot of design work, and the result of that design work is in these packages. We have the upcoming weeks of work for me to assemble all this onto the marble machine X. Very exciting stuff. So let's open them. We have to start with this one. Only open when Wilson is watching. Wow. Hello. Howdy. Look how well they collaborate. Alex CNC, thank you so much. This was so cool. Wilson was a mistake. I'm at the wrong toolpath here. So Wilson is a completely art by accident and has taken a life on his own. This is from Carlos Montoro, guitar luthier from Barcelona. Wow. So this is the pickguard for the Marble Machine X Cyberbass with four microphones installed and electronics. I love the brushed surface. Please burn here. Custom string bass B&B microphone pickups. These are individual volume control for each string. This pickguard will snap right in place on the Cyberbass. Shout out to B&B pickups for this custom wired pickups, and shout out to Carlos Montoro for being so awesome. Next package. So this is a classic laser cut order. What have I done? So a couple of videos ago, I made these plywood parts. These goes together perfectly. So thanks to Alex CNC for making sure these pieces came here. I nailed the tolerances, but it goes all the way in, no filing. This is quite involved. So here's two packages from another superhero of the Marble Machine X team, Tim Keller. Tim is a machinist and has been making these. These are holders for the funnel PMMA pipes. This is so beautiful. These are the actual machined funnel openers. As you can see, it's a box full, so it's like 15 of the same little sub-assembly. So this is the funnel prototype, and here's the final version. Hat off to you. I know how time consuming this piece is. Here's another one. I have no clue, but it says Wilson Cookie. It's from Bert Heiss. Well, I have to spray lacquer Wilson Cookie because we don't want to get rid of him. Thank you, Bert Heiss, for sending the Wilson Cookie. That's great. This is actually jam inside. This one, I know what it is. This is very exciting. We are doing a collab with DIYer, which has a fantastic CNC bending machine. They are helping us bending all the time for the funnels. Wow, they have done an amazing job. Perfect. So they're all unique and they will all fit into Tim Keller's bass. Huge shout out to DIYer for helping us with this. We're gonna cover this in an upcoming video. Last but not least, another package from Alec. Wow. So this is an electric motor, huge 3D printed pulley on the other side with a custom built controller that Alex have built. I had the thought to connect an electric motor and drive the Marble Machine X, and the motor will keep a perfect RPM. But Alex didn't go only for a speed controlled motor. He came up with a super cool system where I can also use the motor as a support when I'm cranking the machine, which is quite heavy. And with this potentiometer, I can adjust how much support I'm getting, just like an electric bike. I can decide the tempo of the machine, and this motor is just helping me. We also have a governor mode that Alex is programming right now, which will actually allow me to start normally with the crank. And when I'm happy with the tempo, I can let go of the crank and the motor immediately takes over. I can stage dive. It's the stage dive machine. I thought that putting an electric motor on the Marble Machine X would be super bad. But when this little thing frees up more of my creativity, I don't know if I'm so much against it. So of all these amazing projects that I have lined up over the coming days and weeks, I think I will start here because this is so exciting. So these are all the projects ready to be rolled out. Hook up the motor, mount pick guard, assemble the funnels, assemble the bass drops. These are also the parts for the drum drops. Design the internal marble routing. Last but not least, the revenge of the Kinetic Fingers. Audio, compose music, record, release, world tour. The plan is set. Let's do this. Oh no, resonator pipes. Oh. Vibraphone resonator pipes. I know I've been talking a lot about attention and focus, and I have to say, to me, standing here today feels completely different than before I went on my trip. I have been working 3 days now with no internet, with no telephone. 6 days out of seven, I will be here executing from morning till evening with no distractions. I feel so much happier now than I did ever last year, I think. So shout out to the video team, Chris and Hannes, and shout out to all the engineers in the engineering team for everything you have helped with for the Marble Machine X and for allowing me to focus like this. By the way, I just saw a super cool video by Maureen from Meticulae Designs about the kinetic fingers. She has animated the movement of the kinetic fingers to the Amelie song and explains the role of the kinetic fingers in a really good way. She also shows a flaring design compared with a rigid design. We will go for the rigid design, but anyway, I just wanted to shout out this video because I loved it so much. It made me so happy to see a fellow believer in the kinetic fingers. I'll leave a link in the description. Go check out Meticulae Designs' animation of the kinetic fingers. See you on the next week. Shh.